And welcome to the Dr. Bob Show. Several shows ago, three or four shows ago, we had a show on GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease. The guest was Dr. John Haydeck. Wonderful show. And you may want to refresh your memory on GERD, gastroesophageal reflux disease, by going to Dr. Bob Show YouTube channel. So go to YouTube channel, Dr. Bob Show, and search for John Haydeck, H-A-Y-D-E-K, because he did such a good job. Well, we're going to expand that because do you know that GERD, reflux disease, can cause other problems, other serious problems? Do you know that you could have sinus disease due to GERD? That you could have chronic hoarseness due to GERD? The sore throat that you wake up every morning and you wonder if something's wrong could be due to GERD. Do you realize that you could have pneumonia, pneumonia in the lungs because of GERD? At least two different ways it can cause that. Do you know that GERD can be involved with obesity, with obstructive sleep apnea? GERD can? So you can have GERD, it can be asymptomatic. So you could have asymptomatic GERD, sinus disease, chronic sore throats, vocal cord function problems, making you think you've got asthma and wheezing, pneumonia, lung disease, recurrent bronchitis, all of that because you don't even know you've got GERD. We'll be spending most of this show talking about it. It's very exciting. My guest is Dr. Matt Moore. Dr. Matt Moore is a board-certified gastroenterologist, stomach specialist. He also has special training in something called ERCP, not important right now. But what is important, in his training at Vanderbilt, he trained with a leading authority in the world on how GERD causes other problems in the body. And we are so excited to bring that on the Dr. Bob Show. I'm Dr. Bob Overholt, Dr. Robert Overholt. I'll be your host for the next 30 minutes on the Dr. Bob Show. Later on, we're going to be talking about COVID-19. Now, COVID-19, the information we get changes, it seems like, every day or every week. And what we thought was right before, like wearing mask or not wearing mask or wearing two masks or no mask or mask only when you go to bed or whatever, we're learning every day. In fact, I've got two masks right here. I carry them around with me. But by the time this show gets on the air, it may be that that's changed. So I want you to know that everything about COVID-19 is rapidly changing because we don't know enough about COVID-19. But we do know how it harms certain parts of the body. And I'm going to talk and teach about COVID-19. The damage that it can cause in the lungs and why it causes damage in the lungs and where it causes the problems in the lungs. Same thing can be going on in the heart. Same thing can be going on in the brain. So if you know anybody that's had COVID-19, and most of us know somebody that's had COVID-19, or you've had it, or you had what you thought was a simple case, pay attention. It may not be as simple as we think. I am so excited about this show. We're talking with Dr. Matt Moore, board-certified gastroenterologist, stomach specialist, and we're going to be talking about how GERD can cause other problems in the body. Remember, I want you to go to the Dr. Bob Show YouTube channel and look at John Haydeck talking about GERD. Now we're talking with Matt Moore, board-certified stomach specialist, about how GERD can cause other problems. Matt, welcome to the Dr. Bob Show.
Thank you for having me.
It's great having you. One of the training you had was with one of the world specialists when you were at Vanderbilt in Nashville, who looked at, and he was a guru in other things that GERD causes. What was his name?
His name is Mike Viese.
So it's Viese. And so you've had significant training in these other things that can happen.
Yes, sir. He's the godfather of all this kind of weird stuff that reflux can do.
Well, you're kind to say that because I'm calling you that tonight. So Let's talk a little bit. Let's refresh very briefly. What is GERD, gastroesophageal reflux? And then we're going to talk into how it can cause other problems.
Sure. So reflux is movement of contents from your stomach up into the esophagus. Everybody does this. It happens to everybody on a daily basis. Most of us never feel it. When it becomes a GERD or a reflux disease is when it starts occurring more often and causing more symptoms or problems.
Do people know all the time when they've got GERD?
Usually not. Most people never notice when they have it, but a lot of people do have more sensitivity or notice it a lot.
Do they wake up in the middle of the night with GERD and it gives them a funny feeling and they've got to go do something about it?
People tell me this every day. This happens very often.
Okay. So let's talk about if you've got GERD, reflux. It comes from the stomach and it goes how far up the esophagus?
So it can come all the way up the esophagus and sometimes even out the mouth. And that's very frightening when that happens, especially when people are sleeping and they're regurgitating and things are coming out their mouth and it's waking them up.
Does that really happen?
It can, absolutely.
Wow. So let's talk about, first thing, sinus disease. So sinuses are up in the head and they can get infected, and some people have recurrent sinusitis, sinus infection. Can GERD cause sinus disease?
So we think so. There's been several studies looking at a correlation or a cause and effect mechanism of reflux actually causing sinus disease. They think they very well can do it. We think it's likely doing that. What's happening is reflux is coming up into the oral pharynx, and probably due to direct contact is causing some inflammation in the sinuses, causing them to possibly get plugged off and then causing problems there.
Yeah, and looking, we see a lot of sinus disease in an allergy practice. We see the sinuses trying to open up to the airway, and if something's blocking it, like inflammation from reflux from GERD, or we see polyps and allergy and other things. So GERD theoretically can cause inflammation of the drainage area of the sinus. So if somebody has recurrent sinusitis, one of the things that people should look for, well, do you think it could be silent GERD or GERD that you're having causing your sinus disease?
Well, after you have evaluated them and you told them, possibly this is it, we don't see anything else structurally, then absolutely they should come see us.
And sometimes from an allergy standpoint, it's amazing how many people will respond to treatment with GERD. I don't have GERD, I don't feel anything. Well, do you burp a little bit more than normal? And they'll respond to it. So let's talk about bad breath and bad taste. How does GERD cause that?
So there again, kind of very similar mechanism. We think it's going to be reflux coming from your stomach. Oftentimes this can occur in the middle of the night and you'll wake up in the morning with just barely a bad breath or bad taste in your mouth. Probably there again. Most of the time it's not going to be obvious. You're not going to wake up with fluid in your mouth or things like that, but you may wake up with a scratchy throat. You may actually be able to do this, and then you've got this bad taste or bad breath, and it's probably due to microscopic amounts of this stuff coming up out of the esophagus and into the airway at nighttime.
So even small amounts can come all the way, especially if you lay on your back?
Absolutely.
So that makes it easier for reflux to cause problems. I wake up clearing my throat every morning and I'm a horse. Why is that?
Probably, we think there may be two mechanisms that's doing that. One may be what we've talked about already with microscopic amounts coming up. Also, we do think there could be a correlation with that happening where you're getting some reflux that's coming into the esophagus. That may be stimulating some nerves that are actually causing some things to change up in the airways. We know that that's a very sensitive area up there. And when you're having this distension of the esophagus or widening of the esophagus from reflux disease, it actually may be causing your brain to send neurons down that's actually causing some inflammation to occur there.
So reflux can send a message to the brain, or it can come through a cranial nerve. Vagus nerve, is that the one?
That would be it.
So that's the vagus nerve. So sometimes treating the vagus nerve may help, may not. It depends. It's wide gamut of things that can cause. So we've got hoarseness in the morning, we've got bad taste, bad breath, and it could all be due to reflux disease. The vocal cord is where?
Vocal cords are down in the back of the throat, kind of in that hypopharynx area there.
So it's in the same area that we're talking about, the vocal cords. So what happens to the vocal cords then? Is that why you get hoarse?
So I see a lot of people that have seen an ear, nose, and throat physician. They may have had a scope done down their nose and looking at their airway, and they'll come see me and say, I've got redness, or I've got a polyp, or I've got some these little things called granulomas on my vocal cords, and they think that they have reflux. And we think that probably is due to direct irritation there. Now, up in that area where the vocal cords are, you lack some of the defense mechanisms that actually help you to keep you from having any injury. So a lot of times when you're having reflux disease in the esophagus just kind of washes that back down. When it gets up here, we don't have all that movement that'll push things back down. So then we think that there's also a change in the environment up here that'll cause some more irritation.
So what does saliva do when I swallow and I think of lemons and I get a lot of saliva in my mouth? What does that do to the acid? Does that neutralize it, help it?
It absolutely does. So when you're chewing, your saliva, it helps moisten the food, but then it also acts as, it's a base, so it helps neutralize the acid that could be coming up.
So if you've got a dry mouth, absolutely, and you always wake up with a cotton mouth, then it could aggravate the neutralizing effect of saliva on the acid that comes up in large amounts or small amounts, and it's causing the irritation there. Sinus disease, hoarseness, vocal cord disease. We've got a disease called vocal cord dysfunction, where some people will actually wheeze because the vocal cord's not doing what it's supposed to do. And instead of wheezing when they breathe out, it's... And a lot of people think they've got asthma just because of what you're talking about. So it could mimic asthma, it can cause recurrent sinus disease, it can cause hoarseness, it can cause vocal cord irritation, bad breath. Can it cause problems in other parts of the body, like the lungs?
Yes, absolutely. We think
that
happens.
And that's what we're going to be, boy, I cut them off quick. And that's what we're going to be talking about. How in the world can reflux disease cause problems with the lungs, like asthma, or like pneumonia? Because it can certainly do it. If you're having recurrent inflammation in your lungs, it could be GERD. You'll want to stay tuned. We're talking with Dr. Matt Moore, board certified gastroenterologist, stomach specialist, and we're talking about GERD, how it can cause other problems. Sinus disease, we've explained that the acid can come all the way up to the sinus openings and cause inflammation there. It can cause inflammation in the back of the throat and have a dry, sore throat every morning. It can cause the vocal cords, which are right back in that area that's not really protected, to also have damage done to them. Chronic laryngitis, it would be. And so it can cause lots of problems with bad taste, bad breath, sore throat, sinus disease. And now we're going to be talking about GERD, how it can cause other parts of the body problem. First, one question I forgot to ask. How does that acid easily get back up into the throat? The esophagus is supposed to squish it down. So how does it get back up there?
So you've got the muscle at the bottom of your esophagus, and it's called the lower esophageal sphincter. Most people refer to this as the flap. And this flap is constantly opening and closing. It allows food to pass through and then should close back. And if it did that, it'd be a perfect mechanism. However, this thing seems to open up by itself at times, even when you're not eating or swallowing. And that's when things come back up.
And when they come back up, how do they go all the way? Is it because of posture, obesity, the way you sleep, sleeping on your back? What would it be?
A lot of times we know that anything that increases the pressure in your abdomen can do this. Tight girdles. If you're pregnant, you're a lot more likely to have reflux disease.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure there.
If you are overweight or carrying too much weight in your belly, that can definitely do that as well. If you're eating a big meal, especially if it's got a lot of fat in it, sits in the stomach for a long period of time.
So if you eat a fatty meal, it makes it where the food doesn't go really through the stomach, so it keeps it in there and makes the reflux worse.
Distends that stomach out.
Yeah. So, great explanation. Now, let's talk about GERD, reflux disease, and the lungs. How does it cause problems?
So, several different ways. We think number one is just that microaspiration that can occur at any time.
Microaspiration. What does the aspiration mean?
So, small amounts of fluid that's coming up through the esophagus and then coming into the airway, possibly going down through the vocal cords.
So you could breathe it, and it could go. You could aspirate it.
And go into your airways. Absolutely.
And if that acid goes in the airways, not supposed to be there, what happens?
Irritation, big time irritation.
Enough where you get just bronchitis, or you get pneumonia where it's sick, big time.
Could be both.
So it could be both. Now, is there a reflex in the middle of the esophagus from those nerves from the brain, the vagus nerve, that sends a message to the lungs to have problems?
I think so. We think there is. We think there is this reflex we were talking about that causes the airways to constrict off. And so that could be definitely a correlation with asthma.
So when we see people with chronic asthma, there's a great percent of those that have chronic asthma. As many as 80%, they say, will have reflux disease. So that's sending a message up. So one of the things, if we see somebody with chronic asthma, if you've got chronic asthma, be sure you don't have GERD or that somebody's looking at that. So we want to be sure that GERD is not aggravating the asthma, because sometimes can we treat that reflux, that problem with reflux?
So definitely if you have normal symptoms of reflux, heartburn, you're regurgitating, things are coming back up on me, those folks tend to do very well if you treat the reflux, and a lot of times their asthma will respond. And then sometimes people that don't have reflux disease will also respond to treatment for the reflux.
So it's getting more and more like GERD can cause anything. So it's important if people are having things that they get the right diagnosis. How do you really diagnose GERD, reflux?
So there's not one single test that will tell you, number one, if you've got GERD or if my GERD is causing any of these other problems we've talked about. A lot of times what you'll do is you'll start with an upper endoscopy.
Upper endoscopy, what does that mean?
So an upper endoscopy is an upper scope. So it's a scope to where you go in and you take a nap. After you're asleep, you get a small scope that's got a camera and a light on the end of it. It goes down the back of the throat and into the esophagus to look at this.
So you can see with a camera, with optics, what's going on in the esophagus all the way down, how far?
You can go a long way, but we usually stop in the small intestine.
In the small intestine, so that means you go through the esophagus, through that sphincter you talked about, into the stomach, through the duodenum?
Yes.
And into the small bowel there.
Right.
Wow. So you really get a good view, and you've got a camera that's looking at that.
Yes.
So what do you see if somebody, doc, I've never had any reflux or GERD or anything. I just came in here because the sinus doctor told me to do it. What do you see when you look down there that somebody has got something that says, boy, you've got GERD?
Sure.
How do you know it?
So a lot of times you'll see erosions, or what the erosions
are.
Erosions are like skinned up spots. I fell, skinned my elbow, and that's what it looks like on the inside here.
So you can scratch the inside, it looks like. It's called an erosion, okay. Yes.
Other things you might see is you might see a large hiatal hernia, and a hiatal hernia may give you a clue that this is maybe more reflux related.
So a hiatal hernia is where, I think, contents from the stomach go, the diaphragm opens up and lets things invade toward
your stomach's coming up into the chest a little bit. It's moving that little flap or the sphincter muscle up some, doesn't work quite as well, maybe relaxing more, causing more reflux disease to occur.
So when you look down with EGD, upper endoscopy, big medical words, when you look down, can you tell if there's a hiatal hernia by looking all the way down? Can you tell if that's causing acid to burn the esophagus and cause erosions?
Definitely, if there's the erosions there, you've got the diagnosis pretty much made at that point.
Now, I think it's really important here that we talk about the lining of the stomach and the lining of the esophagus and something called Barrett's esophagitis. So tell me, what's the normal lining of the esophagus?
So you typically have esophageal tissue that's running the lining of the esophagus. But if you've had chronic reflux disease, sometimes you'll start getting stomach or almost intestinal type tissue that starts coming into the esophagus.
Is that because it's trying to protect you?
Right. So tissue in the wrong spot trying to protect itself.
So can you tell that when you're looking down with your scope?
Okay, yes.
What does it look like, Barrett's esophagus?
So it almost looks like a salmon, like almost like a piece of fish salmon. It looks that's the change in the color that you have there. So it should be kind of a lighter pink. This becomes more of a kind of a brighter pink when you look at it.
And so when somebody somebody's got Barrett's, you say, whoa, they're having chronic problems that are there. And Barrett's can lead to what?
Barrett's can lead to esophageal cancer.
Is that common or not common?
Not very, very uncommon.
Not common, and yet one of my very good friends had that same thing. He didn't even know he had reflux, that he had GERD. And so there were changes in his esophagus called Barrett's. And that friend has a large tumor, cancer in that area. So it may be rare, but when it happens to you, it's a different thing.
100%.
So you can see that down there. And is there treatment that we have for Barrett's esophagitis?
Yes. So we found out that some of the reflux medications can protect you from getting Barrett's esophagus. And then we've got other tools that if the Barrett's looks like it is making that transformation over to cancer, we can actually burn it or use a fluid to actually freeze it to make that tissue go away.
So are there good medicines to cool down the fire in the stomach from reflux?
Oh, yes, sir.
And that's what we're going to be talking about when we come back. I'm going to extend the show another 4 minutes with Dr. Moore because he's got so much information to tell us, and it concerns you and me so very, very much. So stay tuned. We're going to be talking about how you treat all this and how hard and how easy is it in 4 minutes.
The Dr. Bob Show proudly recognizes the Knoxville Academy of Medicine and the Knoxville Academy of Medicine Foundation for their demonstrated leadership in developing community initiatives to improve the health of East Tennessee.
We're talking with Dr. Matt Moore, board certified stomach specialist, and it amazes me of what reflux disease can do, anything from sinus hoarseness, bad breath, vocal cord problems, can even cause pneumonia, can aggravate asthma. Sometimes there's a misdiagnosis. Can it mimic gallbladder disease or heart attacks?
Yes, sir.
I hear a lot of people that will tell me, I have to have my esophagus dilated. Is that because the acid has narrowed it? Why do you dilate the esophagus?
So there can be a lot of little small areas in the esophagus that can get narrow. It's causing food and things to get stuck there. So we're able to actually, when we do that upper endoscopy or that scope looking down into the esophagus, we can actually stretch that open and cure that problem during the procedure.
So I got to tell you a personal story. There was one time when I ate a piece of chicken, it just wouldn't go down, and it really sort of bothered me, and it finally went down in a period of a minute and a half, or that was a long minute and a half. And then I didn't tell anybody, and it happened a second time. So I called up my brother, who was a gastroenterologist specialist, and said, Gene, I've had chicken stick twice. He said, it's probably nothing, but we are obligated to look down. So he did an EGD, upper scope on me, and to be frank with you, I was scared to death of somebody sticking a tube down my throat. Didn't know it. I was out during the whole time. I woke up and he says, you're fine. And I said, have you already done it? He says, yes. So it really is a professionally done where it doesn't bother people. So with that in mind, how important is it to have endoscopy if you've got all of these different symptoms?
I think it's very important to do it because it could lead to major problems down the road. And the quicker we can make a diagnosis, the quicker we can help.
So there's nothing like the EGD looking down to find all of these other things that you might not even think are due to the reflux disease. Matt Moore, you are a phenomenal teacher, and your understanding of how reflux disease can cause so many other problems just puts me in cloud nine, knowing that we've been able to tell people that your recurrent illnesses may have an underlying problem with gastroesophageal reflux disease. Come back again.
Thank you so much for having me.
And now we're going to want to continue. We're going to be talking about COVID-19. Now, this is mid-July. I've got two masks. By the time you watch this, maybe masks will be in vogue, maybe they won't be. We're learning every day about how COVID-19 happens. We don't know how it spread at the time of July 2020. We don't know why some people get it and don't get it. We don't know why some people are asymptomatic and other people it hits like mad. We don't know why some people seem to have a simple case and then it comes back as a, what I call a big time case. So let me give you some facts that we do know. The COVID-19 is a virus. the virus can attack the body in the lungs. And let's talk about the lungs, because some people get severe lung disease. We have at the bottom of the lungs little air sacs. They're called alveoli. And there's a lining of those alveoli called endothelial cells. And we know that COVID-19 sets up inflammation in the endothelial cells. So when we get studies or x-rays, we can see the huge amount of destruction that occurs to some people because the COVID-19 virus attacks the air sacs, the alveoli. So if you're asymptomatic, sometimes you don't know that that may be coming back later on. Think about it. Talk to your doctor about it. Know what your treatment should be. Don't take COVID-19 lightly, because know that it may come back and cause problems. So take care of yourself. Pay attention. Pay attention to science. Science will direct you onto what is good. And now remember, we've got to be exercising. It's so important to your health. We've got to be sleeping 7.5 hours every night. So important to your health. We've got to eat properly, better foods. You'll be, what you eat is who you are. And most of all, what is it we like? It's that laughter in your life. Socialize, laugh a lot. You'll stay healthy, and it will help you through any illness you have. Be sure and giggle.